So who's going to succumb to the adrenaline first? Van Niekerk is running blind on the outside and he's set off really quickly. Karani James in hot pursuit. He's already up onto the shoulder of Matthew Hudson-Smith. And Merritt is tracking the Grenadian. The American, LeSean Merritt, closing the gap on Karani James. And Van Niekerk still wide on the outside. These three are away and clear. Sardinio's tried to come back into it on the inside. And LeSean Merritt coming back at Karani James. But it's Van Niekerk leading at the moment. The South African now beginning to tire. Or is he? He's pulling away. It's an unbelievable victory by a huge margin. A century of history. And 43.03. I can't believe it. He has obliterated Michael Johnson's world record. It was destined to be one of the great races and one of the great days. We haven't even seen Usain Bolt yet, and this has ignited the stadium. Where did that performance come from? The world champion
in a time that nobody has ever done more quickly and more brilliantly. And the nation of South Africa will be rejoicing now. They've been talking about him as a future Olympic champion for some time to come. Now he is one, and he's not only that, he's the quickest man over 400 metres there has ever been. Karani James could not get to him. He's run sensationally to run 43.76. LeSean Merritt was brave as well in 43.85. And Sardinio has run a national record at 44.01. But the night belongs to the South African.
That was utterly, utterly breathtaking. Merritt, 43.85 for the bronze. The slowest athlete in that race was Great Britain's Matthew Hudson. Folded and produced nothing. They both ran incredibly quick times, 43.76 and 43.85 for silver and bronze. Brilliant runs from both of them, but it was on another level there from Wade Van Niekerk. The way he accelerated in the last 50 metres was something to behold. Well, Usain Bolt broke that incredible 200-metre world record of Michael Johnson, but we thought the 400 mark was set to last at least another decade.